Welcome to WCRI's Kids Hour. Whether you're a child, teen, young adult, or just young at heart, we hope to show you a world filled with music and the arts. It's all around us. It's in your favorite cartoons, TV shows, movies,
inconceivable,
video games, musicals, theme parks, and so much more. It's everywhere. During this show, we'll explore the many ways music and the arts are a part of everyday life, and maybe even get a visit from a special guest from time to time.
You don't say!
So, come along with us as we learn and have fun, but most of all, we'll enjoy lots and lots of wonderful music. WCRI's Kids Hour is brought to you by Newport Classical. Newport Classical has brought memorable concerts and inspired programs to some of the most beautiful venues in Newport and the surrounding area. For more information on Newport Classical or to donate, please visit newportclassical.org. Oh, we better go. I hear the orchestra getting ready for today's show.
Hello, kids, parents, young adults, and young at heart. My name is Jamie, and we are back once again with another WCRI's Kids Hour. I'm here with my co-host, Skylar. How are you today, Sky?
I'm doing great.
Well, the concert hall doors are closed and the orchestra is ready, so let's start the show. But before we get started, Skylar, let's thank our sponsors.
None of what we do is possible without the generous support from the Carter Family Charitable Trust, the EJMP Fund for Philanthropy, the Grubin Foundation, and other generous supporters just like you. Thanks!
So, Sky, what do we have in store for everyone on this episode of WCRI's Kids Hour?
Today, we are going to listen to the classic Peter and the Wolf by Sergei Prokofiev. This is a simple story about a young boy called Peter who lives with his grandfather, who warns him about being outside because a wolf roams the woods. However, when the wolf threatens his only animal friends, a duck, a bird, and his grandfather's cat, Peter decides to ignore his grandfather's warning and save them. Yes, Peter turns out to be quite the hero. What is so fun about this story is that we have music and a narrator, so we always know what is happening in the story.
That's so cool. Newport Classical is presenting a children's concert called WindSync Performs Peter and the Wolf on August 17th. If you would like to see that concert, it is free, and you can find out more and register at newportclassical.org. WindSync is an amazing group. The ensemble regularly coaches at training programs nationwide, collaborates with youth orchestras, and performs for thousands of young people each year. They'll put on a great performance of Peter and the Wolf. You know, Sky, the narrator of this recording is the wonderful Boris Karloff, who also narrated How the Grinch Stole Christmas. I bet some of our listeners know that music as well. Sergei Prokofiev wrote both the text and the music for a children's theater in 1936. The work is in three sections. First, an opening that introduces all of the main characters. Then the middle section that has lots of exciting action. And last is the finale that has all the characters in a triumphant parade after they catch the wolf. Let's get started.
I'm going to tell you the story of Peter and the Wolf. If you listen carefully, you'll observe that each character in this tale is represented by a different instrument of the orchestra. For instance, the bird by the flute. The duck by the oboe. The cat by the clarinet. The grandfather by the bassoon. By the three horns. The Peter by the string quartet. And the rifle shots by the kettle drum and the big drum. Early one morning, Peter opened the gate and went out into a big green meadow. On the branch of a big tree sat a little bird, Peter's friend. All is quiet, chirped the bird gaily. She was glad that Peter had not closed the gate and decided to take a nice swim in the deep pond in the meadow. Next to the duck and shrugged her shoulders. "What kind of a bird are you if you can't fly?" said she. To this the duck replied, "Well, what kind of a bird are you if you can't swim?" and dived into the pond. Argued, the duck swimming in the pond, the little bird hopping along the shore. "I Suddenly, something caught Peter's attention. He noticed a cat crawling through the grass. Is busy arguing. I'll just grab her. Stealthily, she crept towards her on her velvet paws. Look out, shouted Peter, and the bird immediately flew up into the tree. The duck quacked angrily at the cat. From the middle of the pond, the cat crawled around the tree and thought, is it worth climbing up so high? By the time I get there, the bird will have flown away. Just then, Grandpapa came out. He was angry because Peter had gone to the meadow. It is a dangerous place. If a wolf should come out of the forest, then what would you do? Peter paid no attention to Grandfather's words. Boys like Peter are not afraid of wolves. Grandfather took Peter by the hand, led him home, and locked the gate. Had Peter gone, then a big grey wolf came out of the forest. Thank you.
In a twinkling, the cat climbed up the tree. The duck quacked and in her excitement jumped right out of the pond. But no matter how hard the duck tried to run, she couldn't escape the wolf. He was getting nearer, nearer, catching up with her, and suddenly he got her. And with one gulp, swallowed her down. Now, this is how things stood. The cat was sitting on one branch. The bird on another. Not too close to the cat. And the wolf prowled around and around the tree, looking up at them with greedy eyes. Meantime, Peter, without the slightest fear, stood behind the closed gate, watching all that was going on. Then he ran home, took a strong rope, and climbed up the high stone wall. One of the branches of the tree around which the wolf was prowling stretched out over the wall. Grabbing hold of the branch, Peter climbed over onto the tree. Peter said to the bird, "Fly down and circle around the wolf's head. Only take care that he doesn't catch you." Bird almost touched the wolf's head with her wings, while the wolf snapped at her from this side and from that. How the bird worried the wolf, how he wanted to catch her.
But the bird was clever, and the wolf simply couldn't do anything about it. Meanwhile, Peter made a lasso, and carefully letting it down, caught the wolf by the tail and pulled with all his might. Feeling himself caught, the wolf began to jump wildly, trying to get loose. Only made the rope around his tail tighter. Just then, some hunters came out of the wood. Following the wolf's trail and shooting as they came. Peter, sitting in the tree, cried, "Don't shoot. Birdie and I have already caught the wolf. All you have to do is to help us take him to the zoo." So off they started to the zoo. And now imagine the triumphal procession.
Peter proudly marching in the lead. After him came the hunters, leading the wolf that Peter had caught. Winding up the procession, Grandfather and the Cat. Grandfather shook his head and grumbled, but if Peter hadn't caught the wolf, what then? Above them flew Birdie, chirping merrily. My, what fine ones we are, Peter and I. Look what we have caught. And if you listen very carefully, you'd hear the duck quacking in the wolf's belly. Because the wolf in his hurry had swallowed her. Alive. Thank you.
Thank you.
That's such a great story with cleverly written music. Before we go, we would like to thank our sponsors one more time. None of what we do is possible without the generous support from the Carter Family Charitable Trust, the EJMP Fund for Philanthropy, the Grubin Foundation, and other generous supporters just like you. Thanks!
If you want to see Newport Classical's children's concert, WindSync performs Peter and the Wolf on Saturday, August 17th at 4 p.m., please visit newportclassical.org to register for this free event. Well, that's it for another episode of WCRI's Kids Hour. Make sure you support and enjoy the music and the arts wherever and whenever you can. We'll see you next time, everyone.
Wow, that was so fun. I wonder what we'll listen to on the next show. Thank you for listening to WCRI's Kids Hour, and we'll see you again real soon. WCRI's Kids Hour is brought to you by Newport Classical. Newport Classical has brought memorable concerts and inspired programs to some of the most beautiful venues in Newport and the surrounding area. For more information on Newport Classical or to donate, please visit newportclassical.org. Gotta run! The concert hall doors are about to close. See you later!